Don mentioned the story in The Athletic, and it jumped out at me when I read it. So I'll try to sum it up. Sam Darnold, after, what was it, the Dolphin loss? I think it was after the Dolphin loss. He runs into the room, red-faced, runs into Adam Gase's office, and said, you know what, I don't like what we're doing. These are the things I like. These are the things I want in the offense. These are the things I can do well. And Gase looked at him, kind of grinned, and said, what took you so long? Like, he's playing some kind of mental game with the kid.
No, I don't think so.
But what I would say, the coach should sit the kid down after it's not working, after he's seen Ghost, and go, what works for you, man? Let's do what works for you.
Let's ask. Well, we'll ask Sam today, but maybe it's a matter of Sam being like, no, I'm good. All this stuff is good. I got it. Yeah, I like all this. And he's like, are you sure? You're comfortable? And maybe he just didn't want to acknowledge, I'm not comfortable with half the playbook.
Well, after he slimmed it down, he's been better.
Yeah.
We're in the middle of the Gang Green Report, 98.7 ESPN's Gang Green Report, brought to you by Shiner Bock. It just almost seemed like you're playing mind games with a young kid. You want to break him before you build him back up. But while you're breaking him, you're losing games that you should win. If they'd have won the Buffalo game, if they'd have won the Dolphin game, winnable games, where are they right now? The narrative's completely different.
But that's what happens when you're a team that's still trying to find its way, right? They beat Dallas, and it's finally come together, and then they lose the next three games, right? You beat the Giants and the Redskins, and you look at it, and those are games you're probably supposed to win. What are you going to do against Oakland? Because now that's stiffer competition. They got to just find some consistency. But the fact that they've won two in a row in the first time in forever, you know, that's got to feel pretty good. But reading the article, Michael, I kind of got the sense that, you know, Mono really just messed everything up, right? Because where would they be if he didn't miss three games? Where would they be if he didn't have protection, you know, around his midsection for the spleen? I'm just wondering, I'm waiting for my quarterback to kind of finally wake up and get it, as Peter was suggesting? Or when am I going to feel like he's healthy enough and also not scared? Because I think he played between the offensive line not being very good and the fact that he was overcoming the illness that he had, was he a little, like, scared to take a hit? And now he's feeling better, and now it's, all right, it's on the table, kid. Let's throw some stuff at you that maybe we thought we would have been in this case if he had not gotten sick.
So did
the illness affect this?
It's so hard to judge, though, what we're seeing. Because the Giants are terrible, and the Redskins are brutal. And as Don said, this isn't college basketball. You don't make your schedule out other than the conference games. You actually play what the NFL puts in front of you. So they've done what they have to do. But we also have to sit here and evaluate, is Sam Darnold that much better than he was against the Patriots? Well, the Patriots are a really good team, and he looked lost. The Giants and the Redskins are brutal, and he looked much better. But then the Dolphins are brutal, and he didn't look that great. Although that loss wasn't on him, I just don't know how to judge him. He looks better. He looks more comfortable.
Yeah, but we've all believed in Sam, right? I mean, I never lost faith in him. I thought it was ridiculous to say when you know Jones won a couple of games in a row, he's the better quarterback in New York. I mean, he had mono, but he took a step back because of that, but I think we all believed that he was the right pick and that he was going to be a good quarterback, that he could still be a franchise quarterback. So I always believed, but now you got to attach it to keep getting better. And where does this team now stand? Even if you believe in the quarterback, Michael, is the team any good? Because the offensive line still isn't great, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, look at how many different, that's the sixth different offensive line that they've had since the start of the season.
I'll tell you who's great right now, Jamal Adams.
Well, yeah, he's playing.
He's something.
He's playing out of his mind right now, but that defense overall, when you look at the Giant game, you can't tell me that anybody else on the defense played well besides him.
No.
We talk so much about him taking the ball away from Jones. How many big plays did the Giants offense have in that game last week? So there's your quarterback progressing and getting better, which is so, so important, and I think we all still believe. But now where is this team going and where is this coach going? Because we are very hard on Adam, right, and rightly so, and there's serious questions on whether he's a good coach or not. Can he still win minds over by beating up teams like the Giants and the Redskins, or does he have to start winning some games like the Raider game, competing with the Ravens? Beating the Pittsburgh Steelers, some of the teams that are on their schedule that are much better than the teams they've beaten over the last couple of weeks.
One thing that stood out to me, and I don't think this is a popular stance, Le'Veon Bell doesn't look good. He's not getting any separation. He's not hitting the hole. I know the offensive line is bad, but the series that they had his backup in looked great.
Mm-hmm.
And then Le'Veon Bell continues to just get 1 or 2 yards every single carry, so I wonder what's going on with him. Here's some numbers on the Jets. This is their first 2-game win streak in their last 20 games.
Wow.
It's unbelievable. Now, this is another unbelievable stat from our very own Rich Cimini. Sam Darnold became the second Jets quarterback in the past 15 years to have minimums of 200 yards and one touchdown pass in 4 straight games. Just the second in 15 years. That's easy. 200 yards and one touchdown pass? The only other guy was Fitzpatrick in 2015. 2 straight weeks for Darnold with a quarterback rating of 97 or better. And for this season, he now has 2 games with QB ratings of 113 or better. And for those that can't help get past Darnold's 3.6 QB rating against New England, here are the opposing quarterback ratings against the Patriots here. 65.6 for Roethlisberger, 20.8 for combo of Rosen and Fitzpatrick, 47.2 for Luke Falk, 24.0 for Josh Allen, 61 for Colt McCoy, 35.2 for Daniel Jones, 3.6 for Darnold, 79.2 for Baker Mayfield, now 107.7 for Lamar Jackson, might win the MVP, 74.4 for Carson Wentz. So everybody struggles, it seems like, against Eagles. Not to a 3.6, but he's been better. No,
absolutely. Now, just to clarify, it was after the Jacksonville game, not the Miami game.
Okay.
All right, because so they're 2-1 since that conversation.
And he played better in the Miami game.
Yeah, they I remember it wasn't on him. It's just everybody else collectively was poor. So I guess most Jet fans will just look at it as, I want my quarterback to get better, and then the team stinks so we can get rid of the head coach. But how much responsibility does Gase have if Darnold continues to progress and get better?
If you're going to give him the blame, you got to give him the credit.
So it's really hard, Michael, and I'll be interested to hear the calls when we start to take them, of how you compliment the team and feel good about where they've been over the last couple of weeks, but yet not compliment the coach for it, right? You kind of have to do that.
And it was a very propitious time for Christopher Johnson to say we're not firing him because now he looks better. You don't say that before you play the Patriots. You say that before you play the Giants.
True.